As its name suggests, the sort method of an array sorts the array. So why do we need a toSorted method? toSorted is new in ECMAScript 2023, also known as ES14, which is the standard for JavaScript. We can use these array methods in JavaScript, TypeScript, and with any JavaScript framework or library, such as Angular, React, or Vue. I'm in StackBlitz and created a new, blank JavaScript project. Let's try out sort and toSorted. We'll use sort first. I'll paste in code to define a simple array of numbers and log the numbers to the console. If you want to code along, you can use any set of non-sequential numbers. To sort this array, we'll use the sort method. We call ages.sort and use console.log to display the result. The sort method of an array sorts the elements of the array in place and returns the same array, but in sorted order. The default sort is ascending, and it sorts by converting the elements into strings, then comparing their Unicode values. Looking at the console, that doesn't look right. Notice that it's sorted by the string value of the numbers, not their numeric values, so 6 is after 42. We can provide a comparator function to the sort method to define our own sort criteria. For example, if we want to sort the array of numbers by their numeric value, we could provide a comparator function like this. Looking at the console, that looks better. However, there are some issues with using the sort method. Sort is mutable. It's actually changing the original array. But since the ages variable references the address of the array, not the array itself, the variable isn't changed. So if you have a setter or change detection or a state management library that's watching for changes to the ages variable, it may not recognize the value as changed. We often want to use patterns and practices that treat arrays as immutable. If you'd like more information on mutable versus immutable arrays, check out my prior video, Understanding Immutability in JavaScript. So, how do we sort an array in an immutable way? That's where toSorted comes in. toSorted is similar to sort, but it creates a new array and returns that new array with the sorted elements. Let's give it a try. I'll start by commenting out the call to sort, then call ages.toSorted and display the result to the console. Before we move on, recall from the beginning of this video, I mentioned that toSorted is new in ES14. Depending on which version of JavaScript you are using, you may get a property toSorted does not exist on type number array. To resolve this error, in your tsconfig.json file, set target to ESNext or to ES2023. The JavaScript template in StackBlitz did that for me, so I didn't have to make that change. If you're using TypeScript, TypeScript version 5.2 supports ES2023. If you are using Angular, ensure you're using Angular version 17 or higher. Angular 17 supports TypeScript 5.2. At the end of this video, I'll demo how to set up Angular to use the new ES2023 features. Okay, going back to the index.js file, let's look at the console. Oh! We sorted the array, but it doesn't look any different. Any idea why? The toSorted method does not change the original array, but rather creates and returns a new array, so we need to assign that new array to a variable. Let's try that again. I'll define a new variable to hold the sorted array. Let the ages equal ages.toSorted. We already logged the original array. Let's log the new sorted array as well. In the console, the original array is unchanged. The new array is sorted similar to the prior sort method example. To sort the numbers numerically, we can again use a comparator function. I'll use the same one we used here. In the console, we see that the original array is still unchanged, and the return new array is sorted numerically. So, the key difference between sort and toSorted is mutable versus immutable. Sort sorts the array in place, mutating the original array. And toSorted creates a new sorted array from the original array, treating the original array as immutable. It's a great choice when working in applications that support immutable patterns, such as state management libraries and functional programming techniques. Lastly, let's look at how to use the new ES2023 features in Angular. In StackBlitz, I've created a new Angular project. I'll paste in the code we were using into the constructor. As of this recording, the current Angular template in StackBlitz does not support ES2023. The method is underlined here. Property toSorted doesn't exist on type number array. We see the same error in the console. Looking at the package.json file, we see that StackBlitz uses TypeScript 4.0.2, which does not support ES2023. Let's jump to VS Code. I just created a new project with the Angular version 17 CLI. Looking at the package.json file and scrolling down, notice that it targets TypeScript 5.2.2, which does support ES2023. I'll open the app.component.ts file. As a quick test, I'll paste the same code here. Oh! Notice that we still see that same error. There is one more change we need to make. In the tsconfig.json file, scroll down and change the compiler options, lib setting, to ES2023. Going back to the app.component.ts file, the toSorted method is now valid, so we can use the ES2023 array methods from Angular. So, ES2023 is supported in TypeScript 5.2, which is supported in Angular v17, but you need to configure it to ES2023 to use those features. Thanks for watching. If this video was useful, please like and subscribe.